Good morning, class 6. In the previous classes, we have discussed about the livelihoods. So, we have talked about the different livelihoods. That livelihood, first of all, is a way or mean of earning to help the survival or maintain the survival for the family and for oneself. So, there are different professions which people adopt. Like, if you talk about cities, we have different professions like doctors, engineers, we have maids, then we have sweepers, then we have teachers, we have postmen, you start naming and we have innumerable jobs, right? But when we talk about the village, there you can say there are less livelihoods available. So most of them, they are involved in the farming process. Maybe they have their own fields, or they are working for someone else and earning bread and butter for their family. But then this working in the field is not throughout the year. So they have to look for some other occupation. Sometimes they start working in the nearby areas, in the nearby towns as laborers to earn for a living. Sometimes they start maybe work in the mills which are there in the village or something like this, to earn their living. So we have discussed here these things. Then we have talked about Kalpattu village, where we have seen about Tulasi. She has shared her daily routine, her experience, what all she is doing. She has shared about her husband also, what work he is doing there and how they are managing their life. Then we have talked about Sikar. His situation was little different because he had his own land, whereas Tulasi didn't had her own land. She was working in the land of Ramalingam, but Sikar had his own land and he was working in his own field, and his family was involved in it. The reason being that if they will hire people or laborers from other villages or nearby areas, they will have to pay them. But if the whole family is involved, then they will not have that, whatever earning will be there, that will be with the family. So you can see the difference. But then that is also not sufficient, so they also have to take loan from Ramalingam, right? So all that we have studied in the previous classes, right? So we can continue from today from here. Ramalingam and Karudamma. Yes. In addition to land, Ramalingam's family owns a rice mill and a shop selling seeds, pesticides, etc. For the rice mills, they used some of their own money and also borrowed from the government bank. They buy paddy from within the village and from surrounding villages. The rice that is produced in the mill is sold to traders in nearby towns. This gives them a substantial income. So Ramalingam's family, they have their own rice mill and they have a shop in which they sell seeds and pesticides. They buy paddy from the nearby village, and then the rice that is produced in the mill is sold to traders to the nearby town. So that is the way of earning profit. Sorry. Read again Sikar's and Tulasi's account. What do they say about Ramalingam? So that we have studied, read already, that what they have said or what is their feeling about him. Then terrace farming in Nagaland. That we will read after we have done this agricultural labor and farmer in India. In Kalpattu village, there are agricultural labor like Tulasi and many small farmers like Sikar, and a few big farmers like Ramalingam in India. Nearly 2 out of every 5 rural families are agricultural laborer families. All of them depend on the work they do on their people's field to earn a living. Many of them are landless and others may own very small plots of land. So this is a small village. We have read about it. And their people are Some are working as well as laborer. Then there are small farmers like Sikar. In the case of small farmers like Sikar, their land is barely enough to meet their needs. In India, 80% of farmers belong to this group. Only 20% of India's farmers are like Ramalingam. These large farmers cultivate most of the land in the villages. A large part of their produce is sold in the market. Many of them have started other businesses such as shops, money lending, trading, small factories, etc. So when we talk about our country, the people, farmers who are earning well, like Ramalingam, their percentage is very less. So they tell us that it is only around 20%, while others, the 80%, remaining 80% is working like laborers or working as a poor farmer in someone else's fields. We have looked at farming in Kalpattu. Apart from farming, many people in rural areas depend upon collection from the forest, animal husbandry, dairy product produce, fishing, etc. For example, in some villages in central India, both farming and collection from the forest are important sources of livelihood. Collecting mahua, tendu leaves, honey to be sold to traders is an important source of additional income. Similarly, selling milk to the village cooperative society or taking milk to the nearby town may be the main source of livelihood for some families. In the coastal areas, we find fishing villages. Let us find out more about the lives of a fishing family by reading about Aruna and Parivalan, who live in Pudupet, a village close to Kalpattu. So both farming and collection from the forest, that is people, they collect mahua, leaves, honey, and they sell this to the traders. That is also a way of earning income. Then they sell the milk to the village cooperative. So these things are done to earn profit. Not very far from Kalpattu is a village of Pudupet. People here earn their living by fishing. Their houses are close to the sea, and one finds rows of catamarans and nets lying around. At about 7 o'clock in the morning, there is a lot of activity on the beach. This is the time when the catamarans return with the catch and women gather to buy and sell fish. So these fishermen, they catch fishes and they come back, and their wives are waiting on the beach, bank, or to collect those fish and sell it off. My husband, Parivalan, my brother and my brother-in-law returned late today. I was very worried. They go to the sea together in our catamaran. They said they were caught in a storm. I have kept aside some fish for the family. I will auction the rest. That means she has kept aside some for the family, and rest she will sell it off. The money I get from the auction. Now you know what is auction? Things are being sold, and one price is set, and then people raise the price, and the highest bidder get the thing. So that is auction. One each for each person who went fishing, and the fourth one is for the equipment. Since we own the catamaran engine and nets, we get that share too. We have taken a loan from a bank and purchased an engine, which is fixed onto the catamaran. Now they can go far into the sea so that they can get a better catch. Now, so the share of the fish is done accordingly. Person who are there, they get each one of them. Then one is for the equipment, and the people who own the catamaran engine and net, they get their share also. So since they own it, they got their share for it. The women who buy fish here will carry them in basket to be sold in nearby villages. Then there are others like traders who buy for the shops in the town. I will only finish this auction by noon. In the evening, my husband and our relatives will untangle and repair our nets. Early morning, tomorrow around 2 a.m., they will set out to sea again. Every year for at least about 4 months during the monsoon, they cannot go to sea because this is when the fish breed. During these months, we survive by borrowing from the trader. Because of this, later on, we are forced to sell the fish to the trader and cannot do our auction. Those lean months are the most difficult. Last year, we suffered a lot because of the tsunami. So this is, again, you can see that here also they face the, that bad time is there, and when they are dependent on the traders, so they also have to take loan from him. Rural livelihoods. Before we continue with the rural high livelihood, I will just like to read the terrace farming which we have left here. This is a village called Sizami, which is in the Fake district in Nagaland. The people of this village belong to Chakhesang community. They do terrace cultivation. This means that the land on a hill slope is made into flat plots and carved out in steps. The sides of each plot are raised in order to retain water. This allows water to stand in the field, which is best for rice cultivation. So you can see it in the picture, and that water is left there for some time, which it is good also for rice cultivation. The people of Sizami have their own individual fields, but they also work collectively in each other's field. They form group of 6 or 8 and take an entire mountainside to clean the weeds on it. Each group eats together once their work for the day is over. This goes on for several days until the work is completed. So they have a group, they work together. That means they work in a team, and they work together in the field, and the other group is there which cleans the weeds on the mountainside, and they eat together after the work is done. Now let's continue with their rural livelihood. People in rural areas earn their living in various ways. Some work on farm while others earn their living on non-farm activities. Working on farm involves operations such as preparing the land, sowing, weeding and harvesting of crop. We depend on the nature for the growth of these crops. Hence, life revolves around certain seasons. People are busy during sowing and harvesting and less so at other times. Rural people in different regions of the country grow different crops. However, we do find similarities in their life situations and in the problems that they face. How people are able to survive or earn will depend upon the land that they cultivate. Many depend on these land for work as laborers. Most farmers grow crop both for their own requirement and also to sell in the market. Some have to sell to traders from whom they have borrowed money. For their survival, many families need to borrow money for their work or when no work is available. There are some families in rural areas which thrive on large acres of land, business and other activities. However, most small farmers, agricultural laborers, fishing families, craft persons in the village do not find enough work to keep them employed throughout the year. So till now we have read so many examples, but then we have found out that all of them are not working throughout the year. There are lean months when they have to be dependent on others for their survival. So that's all for today class. Take care of yourselves. Be safe at home. Thank you.